Today we are finding out just how smart you are. What's your diet IQ and how many will you get right? Stay tuned.
Today we are finding out just how smart you are. Let's see how much you know about food and nutrients. Basically, your diet IQ. Mm-hmm. So grab a pen and a piece of paper and get ready to comment below. To keep a man's prostate healthy, men should consume which foods?
The answer is A. Pumpkin seeds and oysters are high in zinc, and the prostate requires more zinc than any other organ in a male's body, especially during puberty and over the age of 50. And prostate cancer is the second most common cause of cancer-related death among American men.
Did you say pumpkin seeds?
Mm-hmm.
But isn't oysters going to heighten that libido?
Oh, I'm very, very impressed. You've been watching our shows, haven't you?
Yes, I've been reading.
You've been learning a thing or two.
So, and also, number two? Oh,
this is
going
to be.
It's number two. Mm-hmm. Oh, to keep your bowels moving and pooping like a rock star.
Ah, I feel good.
What type of fiber should we consume? I got this one, Karen. The answer is C. Insoluble and soluble fiber.
Yay!
Insoluble, soluble fiber provides bulk, which can also keep the bowel clean.
Yes.
And can contribute to keeping you fit and lean and reduce colon cancer.
Keith, I am so impressed. That's amazing. You're like really learning.
You're making me learn. Americans consume 3 million pounds of antibiotics every year. How many pounds are given to livestock each year? I'm waiting for the answer.
Are you ready for the answer?
Yes.
It's D, 28 million. That's a lot. And this question came off of Oprah's website, Test Your Food IQ, and antibiotics interfere with the health of our own intestinal flora, which is responsible for keeping our immune system healthy.
Wow.
Isn't that interesting?
That's very interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, true or false? Junk food diet is linked to lower IQ adults?
It's true. I know. According to a British study, toddlers who consume a diet high in processed foods had a slightly lower IQ later in life, and a study of 4,000 children found that there was a significant difference in IQ among those who had a processed diet compared to the health-conscious diets in early childhood.
So you're trying to say if it's steamed vegetables, things like that, that's good, and if you eat McDonald's, chicken McNuggets, which are processed, or any fast foods that are processed, it's not good.
Right. I won't say anything about McDonald's.
Okay.
I think that's a done deal.
I was just thinking because I stopped eating McDonald's, and that's why I understood about the libido and the prostate better.
Ah, I'm impressed, Keith. You're like freaking me out.
All right. But which foods can make you bloated, miserable, and fat?
Are you ready?
I'm afraid so.
It's D, all of the above. We all have a unique chemical makeup, and what is good for one person is not good for the other, and that includes the foods that we eat. So what is good for one is not good for the other. Got that right?
Gotcha.
And I found this out the hard way. I was eating lots and lots of kale, which health experts, of course, say it's a superfood, and it literally was the root of my terrible, terrible headaches and sinus problems. So I have a sensitivity to kale.
Kale?
I know. It sounds weird, right? Too bad it wasn't, like corn or something like that.
Wow.
Yeah.
All right. Well, true or false? The recommended protein intake is 4 ounces or size of a deck of cards.
It's sort of true and false. Now, the recommended serving size for poultry, fish, or meat is about the size of your fist. All right? Now, although the recommended protein intake is 4 ounces or the size of a deck of cards, this might not be enough for some people. Like, look at your fist and then look at my fist. My fist is smaller.
Mm-hmm.
So 4 ounces might be good for me because a deck of cards fits inside here, but it's not going to be enough for you. And so basically, people who are of a larger frame may not get enough protein. And protein is essential to our bodies because it breaks down into bodybuilding amino acids, which repair and rejuvenate every function in our body.
So you mean like Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, with the size of his hands, he would have to eat?
He would probably have to eat the size of a piano.
Wow. All right. Which foods keep our thyroid healthy and optimal?
Mm-hmm.
I know this one. We already covered this and I remember it's early in stages. It is A, coconut butter, turkey, and seafood. The others contain goitrogen that can inhibit iodine intake.
You're absolutely right. I am so proud of you, Keith. You're really learning a lot. You're going to be like the nutrition rock star.
Right. And the last one, which vitamin is known to help construct DNA as well as prevent birth defects?
The answer is C, folic acid. Although folic acid is equally important for both genders, it plays a major role in preventing spina bifida, and folic acid may help prevent certain cancers, such as cervical cancer, which is what I went through, heart disease, and stroke.
So how many did you get right? Pause this video and comment below how food and diet smart are you.
Mm-hmm. So how many did you get right there, Keith?
Four.
Wow, that's pretty impressive. Do you have like a nutrition encyclopedia down there or anything like that?
I'm hanging around you, I'm learning. Man, all of this brain power has made me hungry. So, what's up for our recipe of the week? That's what I basically come here for. I want to know.
We have Diane Triforis, certified nutritional consultant and certified life coach, making kale-cium, get it? Kale-cium salad. You've got to watch this.
Hi, Karen and Keith. Today's salad that I have for you is kale-cium salad. I'm starting the recipe with 4 cups of shredded kale that's been washed and dried. And in there's also 1/4 cup of shredded carrots, 1/4 cup of shredded purple cabbage, and 1/2 cup of slivered almonds. Now our dressing is the juice from 1 lemon that I'm just gonna put in this little food processor, and about 1/4 cup of balsamic vinegar, and about 1/4 cup of olive oil, and this is about 1/4 teaspoon of Himalayan pink salt, and then I'm putting 4 dates in here. So then we're going to pulverize this until it's smooth, and then we're going to pour all of this over the kale salad and toss it. And this can be prepared the day before you want to use it, or you can also just marinate it for 2 to 3 hours. So if you want a big bang for your calcium buck, this kale salad is it.
I love it. Yep, I'm getting that recipe right now.
You know what? As a matter of fact, I'm going to grab that recipe as well. Now, I know I'm allergic to kale, but you know what I can do? I can switch it up with collard greens. So
I might switch it up. I don't know about the kale, but I'm like, you can make things taste a certain way, but I'm still open to trying.
Well, I'm delighted. And you know what, Diane? Thank you so much for sharing your yummy recipe with us. And next week, we will be looking into something, well, kind of different. So you know what? You're just going to have to stay tuned for that. So until next week, see ya!